I realized that this is, you know, my moment, and everything is focused around that. And but I couldn't even dream about the success I had. I mean, it was beyond what I ever expected. 20 years later now, and you would think that I shouldn't remember anything. I don't remember much of anything else, but truly the Olympic Games is kind of very stark in my mind. It's interesting because you're so alert physically, mentally, and psychologically in many ways that you remember almost every single detail. And in the stadium, it was a roar of the public I never heard ever before, or will never do ever in the rest of my life for myself. So it's just like a moment which was is our untouchable. And I had three races, and they were all very successful, but there were three very different races. I was an ambassador for the Olympic Aid Program, which was the legacy program of the Lillehammer Olympics. They started it with supporting war-affected children. So I was asked to go to Eritrea as an athlete. And just 6 months prior to the Games, I came there as an incredible selfish athlete, focusing on my own pursuit to success. I hadn't expected the impact that trip would have on me in my life. And seeing that as an athlete, it kind of inspired me to become a better athlete. He kind of took me back into my preparation for the Olympics, saying, don't waste my own talent. And I could skate for something bigger, something more purposeful for those kids. And it really, truly catapulted me into a mental space which I never expected in relation to my own performance at the Olympics.
His home crowd, what a treat it would be if Norway could take gold and a world record too. Cost 6:35.53 to beat the world record. Have done.
After my first race and the victory, I felt extremely thankful to the people who supported me on my way to these Olympics. I mean, my family, my coaches, all the people who kind of helped me to get to where I was. Even though we see speed skating as an individual sport, it's actually very much like a team sport. You know, the best team get the best individual athlete in many ways. Going into this, my second race, and I was certainly not the favorite for this is the middle distance 1500, and many other guys was much faster than I would expect to be. And I was thinking, you know, then I was going back to my trip to Eritrea, and the change that made to me and the purpose was given. So I was walking about 3 days thinking, if I'm going to win this, I should give back to these kids, because they kind of put me on this path in the last 6 months to really sharpen my edges. And that promise, you can't really tell anybody. You know, if I win, I was going to give the money away. That just doesn't make any sense to tell anybody.
The world record, 151.6. He's got it. The world record has gone.
So when I did that, I had not expected the incredible results, the mobilization we had within the Norwegian people. One of the people I worked with were saying, Johan, shouldn't we challenge every Norwegian people to give equivalent of 10 kroners, equivalent of a pound, basically, for every gold medal we win in these games? And I said, yeah, that's a great idea, let's do that. And all of a sudden, the journalist was giving money. I had never seen that before. Not that I'm very cynical, but all of a sudden, they were kind of running around with a cup around in the room, and thousands of kroners was collected in that minute. We raised over $18 million in 10 days from the Norwegian people. It was an incredible result with people coming together. Of course, the last race, which was the final race for me, and it was the best race I ever skated, and it was the most unexpected.
Just watch the clock. The world record stands at 13:43.54. That has been taken utterly apart. 13 minutes, 30.55.
I remember after the race, it felt like a big backpack was off my shoulder. The level of relief was unbelievable. I felt like, you know, 20 pound lighter just finishing. And even though I was at physical exhaustion, I felt so energized. And it was a kind of a strange feeling I never had any time ever. And of course, the public of 15,000 people inside the Viking ship had a very good time. So it then influenced me as well.
A gold medal and third Olympic title in the space of 7 days to Johan Olav Koss of Norway. Becomes the first winter sportsman in Olympic history to win three gold medals in the same Olympic Games, all in new world record times.